when we throw a ball, the gravitational force of Earth acts upon the ball and pulling it down, because gravitational force is always attractive force. Newton says that whenever a force is exerting on the body, there is acceleration produced in the body. Newton's second law. So two things are there here. One is, when we throw an object, the gravitational force of Earth acts upon the object and pulls it down. Newton's second law of motion says that whenever a force acts upon a body, in the body, acceleration produces. So that acceleration produced in the body is due to gravitational force of Earth. Therefore, that acceleration is called acceleration due to gravity. Because the gravitational force of Earth is producing the acceleration in the falling body. So it is called acceleration due to gravity. Because when the object is falling downward, its speed increases. Acceleration increases. When the body is going upward, its speed decreases. Acceleration is negative. Okay? Retardation. Retardation means negative acceleration. Acceleration, positive acceleration. Okay. The acceleration produced in a freely falling object due to the gravitational force of Earth is called acceleration due to gravity. Fine. Look here. This is Earth. This is one any object on Earth, a man or a tree, whatever. We are a stone whose mass is M, whose mass is capital M. This is R. Capital M is the mass of Earth. This is R. This is an object whose mass is M. This is mass of the Earth. This is the center of the Earth. And this distance between the object and the center of the Earth is taken as radius of the Earth. Because this small distance is neglected here, because the radius of the Earth is 6400 kilometers. And suppose you can take the height of object is 1 meter or 2 meter, it is very small in front of the 6400 kilometers. So if you add 2 meters to 6400 kilometers, it remains 6400 kilometers. There is no much difference. Therefore, capital R is taken as here, radius of the Earth or the distance between two objects. Then, as we know that the weight of the object here is equal to m into g, and according to Newton, the gravitational force between Earth and this object is g into m divided by r square. But force and weight are same, because it is told that what is weight? It is the force with which the body is attracted towards the center. The force, the gravitational force, which is pulling this object towards the center, is known as weight of this body. So, weight and force must be same. Then put here that, yeah, we write W is equal to F, F equal to W, both are same. Then M into G is equal to G into M by R square. Cancelling M and M, we get G is equal to GM by R square. The acceleration due to gravity depends on mass of the object. Mass of the object and radius. Okay. As we know that the mass of the earth and radius of the earth and the value of g, if you substitute all these values, we get g is equal to 9.8 meter per second square. If you substitute here the mass of moon and the radius of moon, you get acceleration due to gravity on moon. That is some 1.57, in fact 57 or 6 into 6 meter per second square. The acceleration due to gravity on moon, acceleration due to gravity on earth. So acceleration due to gravity on earth is more than moon. Therefore, it is told that the acceleration due to gravity on moon is approximately 1/6 of acceleration due to gravity on earth. Approximately. So if you multiply here m and m, because the mass of the person, whether he is on the earth or on the moon, it won't change. Mass won't change. So if you multiply here m and m, you will get weight. That is mass into gm is approximately equal to mass into 1/6 into mass into g. So it means that weight of the object on moon is approximately 1/6 of weight of the object on earth. Okay, I can find out. Suppose my mass here is 60 kg, whether I am on the earth or on the moon, my mass remains same. Only my weight will change. What is my weight on the earth? That is mass into value of g. 60 on the earth, the value of g is 9.8. This 9.8 approximately it can be taken as 10. So 10, 60 into 10 is 600 newton. My weight on the earth is 600 newton. What will be my weight on the moon? Weight of any object on the moon is mass into gravity on the moon. Since my mass is 60 kg, gravity is some 1.6. That is 6 into 16. 16 6 are, as we know that. 6 6 are 36. 3. 6 1s are 6 plus 3. So it becomes 96 newton. It means that weight of the body changes as it goes from one place to another place, because the value of g changes, the small g changes. On earth it is different, on moon it is different. Therefore, weight changes, but mass never changes. Mass remains constant. Suppose if you take a stone of 10 kg from earth to moon, the 10 kg remains same. If you take 100 kg of sugar from earth to moon, 100 kg remains same. Only its weight will change. Okay? Fine. So weight depends on g. Since small g changes, therefore weight also changes. This acceleration due to gravity is again not constant on the earth. It is not exactly 9.8 meter per second square, because earth is not perfectly spherical. Earth is flattened at the bottom and top. So radius of earth on the equatorial region is more than the radius of the earth on the polar region. Radius of the earth on the equatorial region is more than the radius of the earth on the polar region. Here radius is less, here radius is more. So therefore G is equal to gm by r square. Here radius is more. If radius is more, the value of g here on the equatorial region is less. Because radius is more. But on the polar region, radius is less. G is equal to gm by r square. If radius is less, g is more. So here g is more. So on the polar region, the value of g is more. On the equatorial region, the value of g is less. So even on the earth, the value of small g, that is 10 meter per second square, is not same. That you learn in the higher class. Okay, this acceleration due to gravity was discovered by a very famous scientist known as Galileo. And the experiment is also known as Galileo's Galilei's feather and coin experiment. Feather and coin experiment. He took a feather and a coin. He took a feather and coin and dropped from certain height in the air. Feather took more time, coin took less time to reach the ground. But for that he says that if I conduct the same experiment in vacuum, but feather, the lighter body, coin, the heavy body, would reach the ground at the same time. So if I conduct the experiment, feather and coin experiment, the lighter body and the heavy body in the vacuum, the feather and the coin would reach the ground at the same time. But why not in air? Because air is opposing feather. Therefore, feather will take more time. Coin will take less time. Therefore, he says that the feather and coin, when are dropped from the same height, they would reach the ground at the same time because the acceleration produced in both the bodies, the gravity that is acting upon both the bodies will be same. Earth is pulling them equally by applying equal force. Therefore, acceleration would be same. Therefore, they would reach the ground at the same time. This was the beautiful experiment conducted by Galileo's Galilei. Okay, with this, I close the class. Thank you.